Hello, everybody, and welcome back to SkySaga Alpha 7. This is going to be the very last questing and challenge episode here on Alpha 7 because Alpha 8 has been announced. The hell? Yes, we are going to have Alpha 8 coming out very soon. In fact, so soon that we're not going to be able to get another one of these episodes out because it is going to be out on the day I would normally put this episode out. So my filming and releasing schedule is kind of going to be a little bit messy over the next week and a half, just as I kind of show off some really cool things about Alpha 8 and I kind of get myself back into Alpha 8 and all of that kind of stuff. So we're going to have to, things are going to be a bit messy, but there's going to be a lot of videos from me coming out because I have a lot of really cool things I want to show you guys coming into Alpha 8. Anyway, today we are actually going out and we are doing Fabled Forest Adventures because we've actually finally got that quest, which means that if I jump out of here and have a look at my quests, my current task is to discover 3 landmarks in a Fabled Forest Adventure. Now, if we have a look around, Paige is in here with us somewhere over there, and we have got this little town thing, which is not perfect, because finding 3 landmarks was going to be so much easier if I could just jump down into a cave, because a cave can give you kind of 2 or 3 or 4, depending on how big and long the cave is. But there is a cave here, so that's cool. Alright, so we've got a cave, and now I've got a cartographer. So that's 1 landmark done. Now, I'm really not going to be in this adventure too long. I really want to just hit my 3 landmarks and get out of here, because today we're actually going to do a challenge with XaviusGrey. Now, XaviusGrey, for those of you who don't know and haven't been around the forums, Xavius is an awesome guy, and he is the one that actually set up a lot of the challenges that I've been running, and he gave the ideas for all of these things. So I think it's going to be really cool to have him come along and actually do these challenges with us. So I want to kind of keep this one short, like this adventure short and sweet, so that we can spend lots of time out there with him and actually have a bit of fun with the challenge for this week. But more on that when we actually get to the challenge for this week. Ooh, Siege Tyrant. Hello, you are very powerful. Very powerful indeed. Okay, I'm going to try that again, because that was a one-shot, and I actually upgraded all of my armor before I came out here. Man, that dude is strong. That bow is insane. Alright, I've done a little bit of damage to him. That's what I wanted to do. Okay, cool. Damn, alright, where are my arrows gone? I need to get my arrows back so I can do some more damage back to these guys. Also, I need to put meat on my hotbar, because that's a thing that needs to happen. Alright, let's see if we can help out Paige. Now, I do need to apologize to Paige because I have been saying their name wrong for quite a number of episodes now. They've been out and about and helping me, and it's been awesome to have them out and about and helping, but I have been saying the name wrong. I've been adding too many vowels into the place, so we're going to go with Paige from now on, because I have actually been corrected. So I'm going to stand by that, and hopefully I'm not fucking that up even more. Anyway, I'm going to keep on going through here. There's nothing in that tower, at least I don't think so. I think that's just my death skull on the map up there. So I don't like the look of you. You can go away. Paige and that Warhammer are going to do a lot more damage than I'm going to be able to do with this bow from back here. Yeah, look at that. One swing takes so much more health. Rup, bam! Ha ha, hit you through the door. And the door just goes down. I like how you can kill enemies before you knock doors out in this game. That's just, I find that hilarious, to be perfectly honest, that a door is stronger than a person. Yeah, there you go. I knew you were over here. Your bow is really strong. You can just stop doing that. Alright, so does this count as a landmark? No. No, it does not count as a landmark. Otherwise, we'd have had that pop up. Anyway, let's keep moving on through. Collecting up all of the chest goodness that is around here. I'm seeing another chest on the map. There's the other chest. And hopefully we can then take off and find a next landmark. I'm amazed that I haven't found a landmark for this, like, little town place yet. I found a landmark for the little cave over there, which is great, because I didn't think there was going to be a cave in here. Oops, kind of leaving Paige behind. Guess they'll catch up in a second. Sorry. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. I don't like the look of that dagger coming out of that door. Bam! 800. You can rip. Bam! Oh, okay, and there's just like a window over there? Assassin. Assassin is down. Good. I really don't like... Well, okay, the assassins are kind of fun. They are quite a challenge, so... Tree splitter doublet. Let's put that on. It's probably going to break in this adventure, but it's always worth putting on better armor and using it until it breaks. Okay, anyway, let's continue on through here. Still amazed I haven't got the landmark for this place yet. Let's see if we can take the lout out with sword. Yep, perfect. Guess I shouldn't have really questioned that. Page is going to do most of the damage in this map for us. Which I quite like, because this is my first one, so I am nowhere near specced up enough to actually even be here, realistically. Always good to have help. And something I would recommend, if you guys are playing and you're not, like, playing with people, go and put a post on the forums and, yeah, like, ask people to come and play games and run adventures and stuff with you, or hang around in the City of First Light and ask people, because... These adventures are so much more fun when you have somebody in-game with you and running around helping. Even if you're not, like, chatting, just like me and Paige aren't chatting right now, we're just kind of going along, we have just a mutual goal in mind, and it's cool, it's good, it's fun like that, and it does make these maps more interesting, and like I said, just that little bit more fun. So, something I would recommend. Anyway, let's come over here and kill this guy off. Alright, there we go. Still amazed we're on one landmark and no more. That's just... hang on. Did that landmark even count? Oh, sneak into three fabled landmarks without defeating any creature. Okay. So this is a good thing we've got Paige here then, because now I don't need to defeat creatures. I can just... sneak into landmarks. Alright, I'm just going to fill Paige in on exactly what I need to do. And then we're going to keep going with this. Okay, so I'm thinking my best bet is going to be in the cave. Hopefully we can come down into the cave. There we go. And find some more landmarks. And just run away from everything else. And just let Paige deal with anything that kind of comes too close. Alright, so now that we've found one more over in the cave, over there, did I get one or two over in that cave? I'm really hoping it was two. Oh, it was two, that was perfect. Alright, so that means when we come down the bottom here, this is going to be quest complete. And yeah, I might film the rest of the run, but I may not even add it in, because like I said, I'm really keen to get going and join XaviusGrey out in the world, because... I think that's going to be really cool. Alright, we've done it! That is it! We've actually done this mastery quest now, and that is really, really cool. And I've also ranked up Cartographer, which I didn't even know was a thing before this episode. So, there you go. That's what I love about doing these episodes. I learn just as much as I hope that I am teaching you guys about adventures and all of that kind of stuff, just by doing all of this on the fly. Now, of course, having got all of that ready, I can now actually kill things. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm very much, most likely not going to be using much of the clips that I've taken from here. So we're kind of about halfway through the dungeon, I'd say, at this point, and Paige is kind of being graphically glitched for most of this. So you can have a look over there. Paige is doing some attacking right now, and they're just, like, their character model has been stuck exactly like that for... I don't know, 5, 10, 20 minutes, however long we've been going through here, doing all of this stuff. So, it's a little bit graphically glitched, it's a little bit weird to watch, so I'm probably not going to be using much of this. We'll probably have the next cut being us going through and fighting the boss. And then we're going to get out of here and move on and talk to XaviusGrey. Yeah, I might even... Yeah, if you guys like this type of stuff, I really do want to kind of keep collabing with people going through into Alpha 8. But please let me know in the comments below if you want to see more collabing and stuff going on this channel. Alright, and it is boss time. I've also died pretty recently, so this could be a little interesting. Oh, and that's purple. I've never seen purple before. Uh-oh, that does not look healthy for me. Alright, let's take this guy out with a few pops to the back with a bow and arrow. Let's see if I can keep him down there. Lots of knockback. Paige is really going to be the heavy hitter here. I'm just going to keep this guy distracted and focusing on me. Or something. Alright. What we're going to do is we're going to come down here and join in because... Hiyah is why! Wow, I do like no damage compared to Paige. This is why... It's good to have other people with you because I would be picking this guy down from no health and no damage done. The only thing about playing with other people is you're going to make sure that you guys don't end up opposite sides of the person because then you'll end up hitting them into each other and that's not good. I mean, it's kind of unavoidable when you've got a long situation like this, but it's also not... the greatest thing to do. I'm doing so little damage. I'm so sorry. I feel like I'm pathetic in this fight right now. I need to get a better weapon. Hopefully the level up for this mastery quest gives me that better weapon. But it's not like I'm actually going to use it because, of course, we are almost out of the game. Well, almost out of Alpha 7. So we're going to have to come back and do this again in Alpha 8. I'm going to try... level up a little quicker in Alpha 8, just because I'm actually going to do this from the very start, which means I'll be doing lots more questing every week, hopefully meaning I can actually get through some of these things and get back to heroic adventures or fabled adventures rather quickly. I might even not do common adventures on camera. I might just skip directly to, directly to fabled stuff or directly to heroic stuff, I guess. So that things are a little bit more interesting. Hey-ya! Wow, okay, I'm doing like 300 damage. That's not good. Not good at all. This guy's got so much health. How long have we been fighting him for? We've been fighting him for like 5 minutes and he's still got all of the health in all of the world. Bam! I'm doing like no damage. Oh, did I hit him? I hope I hit him. I had to like change course at the last second. Yes. Oh, and I'm out of stamina. Get out of the way. Rebuild the stamina bar. Bam. Oh, nice. Critical hit. Bam. Oh, he exploded in loot. All right, let's see what we got from that guy. We got, alright, one of the more forest emblem. We got a treasure amber for fabled gear, I think. Furniture recipes. Yeah, and there was something else on the ground. Oh, yeah, there it is. Toxic gem. That's really cool. I like that a lot. Oh, now I'm kind of sad I haven't been to more fableds. Oh, well, let's take a look in the chest at the end here, and then go over and start the challenge quest for the day. Alright, so we've got a little bit of stuff in here. Again, these chests could use a little bit of a buff, I think. Just personally, I think they could use a little bit of a buff. Anyway, that is it for this little adventure. Let's go over and meet XaviusGrey and do a challenge. Alright, and here we are in a heroic Arctic, and we're here with XaviusGrey, and today we're going to be doing the Dance of Death Challenge. And I'll let Xavius take it from here as to what we're actually going to be doing.
So the Dance of Death challenge is pretty easy. Basically, every time you swing your weapon and hit an enemy, you gotta dance.
Okay, are we gonna be dancing before and after, or just after we successfully hit an enemy?
I would say it would probably be easier on hit or on kill.
Okay, I think we're gonna go for on hit, just because so far these challenges have been more fun the more challenging they've been, so... Yeah, every hit you make on an enemy is going to be a dance. So I have now mapped all of my very close buttons and dances. So I've got the Running Man. We've also got the Sassy Lasso, my personal favorite. And then we have the Hip Swing, which is a great move as well. For some reason, my emotes don't seem to make any noise, but that is okay. That's why we've got Xavius along. His emotes can make noise for us.
Yeah, I think they made it to where only your emotes don't make noise, only other people's do.
Okay. That would make sense. All right, so let's head on out here. We're going to try and see if we can actually kill the boss dancing all the way, which I think is quite ambitious, but, you know, that's kind of the point of doing a challenge, I guess.
We'll have to take turns with our hip swings.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you can hip swing if you want. I'm going to Sassy Lasso. I'm going to be so sassy all over that place. So obviously this is our main location. So we should probably have a bit of a quick look around the outside here and see if we can find anything else. So you've got your big hit and stick out. I think I'm going to join you in the big hit and stick.
Sounds like a safe one.
It's also going dark, which means we will have nighttime enemies pretty soon. Doesn't seem to be anything over here, I don't think. Just realized my map's not on. Let's get the map up so we can actually have a look at the landscape around us. So we've got something green over here. Oh, we've got a forest critter. A frost critter. Why did I say forest critter? Bam! Hey, nice! Alright, I probably should swap over to my hitting stick. You're doing a lot of damage with yours.
Yeah, I was gonna say, should I switch to dagger?
Alright, so we've got something over there. We've got like a camp over there. We've also got a champion here too. So, hiya! Oh yeah. Alright, I think I'm probably going to have to stop doing Sassy Lasso because that's a long emote.
Yeah, it is.
Well, where did he go? Did he die or did he get like catapulted?
I think he went through the wall.
It's so weird when that happens. Somewhere. There's a champion over here. Maybe you knocked him all the way over here.
Wow.
Or maybe this is a new champion. Nope, this is a new champion. Huzzah! Alright. And now he's going to come after me while I'm running, man. Oh! Yeah, this is going to be difficult because they are really going to go after us while we're emoting. Whoa, that's a big drop.
Ooh, Running Man's definitely not a good one.
Yeah.
Too long.
I'm not sure which is longer though, the Running Man or the Sassy Lasso. The Sassy Lasso is pretty long. Like, that's a pretty long one.
I think the Running Man's just a tad longer.
Oh, okay. Well, we definitely shouldn't be Running Man doing the Running Man. Also, the chat is just getting absolutely slaughtered with emotes right now. Alright, so there's another frost critter up there, but they die pretty easily. So let's go and take on this place, because this is actually going to be more interesting to take down. Getting mobbed by enemies is going to be much harder when you have to emote after every swing. Hiya!
Got champion, watch out.
Whoa, where did that guy come from? Also, I think I just hit you rather than the champion. I was like... You said, watch out, champion, and I just hit the nearest thing with the horned helmet, and I think that was you.
Well, we do what we have to.
Alright, let's see in here, because there's probably something else in here. Huh, okay, there's no spawns in the building. That's quite unusual. Usually there's at least a couple of spawns in here. There's not even any... like chests around the outside here. Maybe there's a chest up in the top section.
Yeah, I'm just gonna go check. But there's nothing up here.
Oh, okay. Damn. That's really annoying, because like that's the best spot for this thing to be, because then you can just like bust out the side and jump onto the roof and keep going.
I know. I thought it was cool the first time I found one in one of those.
Huzzah! Oh, hang on. I've missed like a rune or something down here. Perfect. That'll actually let me build some armor. Oh, we've got a Yeti. I really want to take this guy down.
Oh, totally.
Come here, Yeti.
Which means can we get in this?
Huzzah! I think this is actually... Like, it's helpful to have a couple of people doing this, because that way he kind of like keeps changing the target that he's going for.
Yeah, it's daggers.
Yeah. Oh, did that hit? That I was like halfway through an animation and I managed to swing my weapon. Oh, I missed. Bam, there he goes. Oh, there you are.
Gray pelt, nice.
Nice. I got white pelts from him, so that's weird.
Yeah, that is weird. Always fun to explore the ruin.
Yep. Usually you get skeletons over in these things, too. Skeletons are fun enemies. Oh, we've got some dreadnoughts. Bam! Sassy lasso. Lots of the sassy lasso. Oh, that dead eye is going to be a pain. Oh, you're right. The running man is the worst. Bam! Oh, that was a kiss. I didn't really want to do a kiss. I guess I could have counted that as... I guess I could have counted that as a dance move, but I was like, nah, I gotta dance as well.
Uh-oh. I hear rock chuckers.
Yeah. I've said this in a couple of videos, but I really, really want to be able to throw rocks. Like, can you imagine being able to craft stone chunks and then taking them into a world and being able to throw them at people? That would be so great. That's
pretty funny. I could just see it in PvP.
Oh yeah, that would get so abused in PvP, most likely. Now it says the lout here. Oh, and I missed. I'm not even sure if I hit that guy. No, I didn't, because I didn't get any loot off of them.
Sorry.
That's alright, I just like
I'm excited.
I made the swings, I just missed. Well, what? All right, let's go down here. So there is a amber down here. Do you want to take that? Because I'm assuming there's only one of them.
Yes, there is.
Oh, that's sad. It was so nice when they actually added multiple drops into the game, so that when you're running a quest like this, everybody that takes part, like, gets some loot from it. So, do you want to break our way in through the window here, or do you want to actually go through...
Sounds good to me.
Alright, let's break our way in through the window. This is not going to be where the, it's not going to be where the hole down is, but it's going to be a good way in. At least this way we'll also fight some more enemies, too. You guys take him. I'm going to take on the captain over here. Kind of get him off your back.
Thank you.
Oh, I missed. Just stop there. Thank you. All right. Bit of a sassy lasso. This guy's like confused right now. He's like wandering around all over the place rather than attacking. And as I said that, I get attacked in the face. Always the way. As you go to say, oh, he's being friendly, you get smacked. Was funny though in the last episode when I actually managed to convert a few enemies into friendlies for a little while at least.
Yeah, I saw that. That was awesome.
Yeah, there you go. Apparently all you need to do to make friends is just to kick people repeatedly. Who knew, right?
Who knew it was that easy?
Look, it's definitely something I'm going to take into my real life and just... use, because that's valuable information right there. And I really should be paying attention.
School, right?
Oh yeah, school would have been so much better. Oh wow, just so much dancing. I gotta love the running man after somebody is dead though. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's poetic at that point.
It's very quiet in here.
It's quiet. Too quiet. Suddenly 20 enemies spawn. Do you want to take on the big chamber at the end down here? Or do you want to go downstairs? Okay, we can take this on.
I brought my beaten stick for a reason.
My beaten stick is getting pretty dead now. It's like 8%, so I might have to swap back to the dagger. But yeah, the dagger doesn't really go too well with this type of challenge.
Let's do it here. Let's bring him to the bottleneck.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a lot of guys, and that's a lot of damage. Whoa. It's always nice when you can like hit a bunch of them at once. Because you can do a lot of damage for every dance move that you do.
You know, the stamina region is nice with the dance.
Oh yeah, that's true. The only time you lose stamina is when you miss, because then you're not... I have to run for a second. I need to find some food.
So okay, I'll try and get it to... Oh no!
Ah!
Run the other way. Here, okay.
Ooh! That was... That was close. I have a feeling
he's
that was...
after you. Run. Okay. He was chasing you.
Yeah, alright. I made the very rookie move of not having food on my hotbar. I think I've talked about this in multiple videos, and I still just don't have food on the hotbar. Alright. Go down, man. You... Just for the chasing after me, you're gonna die now. Yeah. Bit of sassy lasso. Wow, he's really, really keen on me.
Yes, he likes you.
Yeah, well, I don't like him. Just, you can leave me alone. Bam! And he must go down, yes. Perfect! Oh, and he actually counts as a boss. So we get raw materials ambers. I had a plan for something I was going to do with raw materials ambers, but it's a little bit late in the alpha to doing that now.
I know, it seems like I get a whole bunch of really good ideas right before an alpha ends.
Yeah, I mean, that is good though, because you can sometimes like re-roll those into a new build, depending on the changes.
Yeah, I remember Alpha 7 in my island, my PvP arena got saved. I was all excited, and then I got to Alpha 7 and was like, oh man, I gotta redo all of these pillars.
Oh yeah. I haven't actually been, like, I have an Arctic that got saved. My little, like, Christmas candy cane workshop thing. And there's a few pillars in that. Oh, it was good fun to build. It was one of those, like, small but detailed things, which is something that I don't do often, but it's good fun when I do. Wow. Oh, we've got a shield guy. These shields are my, like, least favorite enemy in the entire game. They just feel tedious. I like how we've both just kind of gone over to the sassy lasso, because it's obviously the quickest one.
Yeah.
Yeah, guard down. How are you going with the shield guard? Do you want some help?
I'll be okay.
You are running... You're running low on health there, so I'll give you a bit of a quick hand.
Thank you. Yeah, I was waiting a few seconds to do my sassy lasso after the hit, so I could avoid damage.
Good idea. Alright, so that's cleared out the three-ish enemies that were around here. And I've got two more up here, so... Yeah! Oh, what did I... I think I held it down too long as I tried to jump attack. Oh, that was a hip swing. That wasn't what I wanted to do. Whoop-bam! Yeah! I like it when you can, like, normal attack and kill them. It's always a good feeling. It's like, I'm not wasting time on this, you're just gonna die. Yeah, hip swing. Oh, I somehow managed to jump and attack the pot that was in front of me.
Take that pot.
Yeah. Oh, just... I hate pottery. Just all of the pottery needs to die. Alright, so we've got the cells. Do you want to go down through the cells? I guess we might as well, hey.
There's stuff to hit with our sticks.
Well, hopefully there's stuff to hit with our sticks.
It's back this way.
Hello!
Hello. Two paths, one way.
Yep. Oh, there's a chest back up here somewhere that I missed, so I'm just going to quickly grab that. Oh, there it is. It's on the other side. Tucked away.
Yeah, it's kind of hidden.
Yeah. It's sometimes nice when they do that, because that way you like see it on your minimap. You're like, oh, I've got some more stuff I can go and have a look at. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, of course, sometimes it can drive you insane. I had a maze where I had a chest buried 2 blocks deep in a wall of the maze. It was driving me insane trying to find it until I finally just dug it out.
It's yeah.
It's like, a chest in a wall.
Somebody who really doesn't want you taking their stuff.
It seems too quiet in here. I feel like it's a trap.
It does feel a little like a trap, but let's spring it. There is a guy to the left. Oh, this is a really cool build. I really like the like braziers behind the glass. That's really awesome. Oh, you engage somebody. Bam!
Yeah, he wandered over, so.
Just so much sass right now. Man, my inventory is full as full can be. Just give me 30 seconds. I just need to, like, sort some stuff out, work out what I want and what I don't want. Alright, there we go. Okay, so we've got one way down this way, and we've got one way over this way, maybe? Or maybe this is just a room. Okay, this is just a room. So, it's over this way, I think.
Yep, oh, nave.
Oh, okay. Oh!
I just saw the horned helmet.
Bam! Okay, he's annoyed at you, so I'm gonna go around behind and put some damage in from behind. Because this way, oh, I can just ignore the shield completely. Bam! Really gonna have to like do lots of charging if I'm just gonna use the dagger. Oh man!
Behind
Bam!
You.
Yeah, I know, I'm running away from it. Bam! Get away from me! Admittedly, charging weapon attacks actually do a lot more in this alpha than they've ever done before, like...
Yeah.
They're actually usable and useful.
Actually, I love the sword charge attacks. That was hard to say.
Little bit of a tongue twister, that one.
Got a chest over here.
And we've got some enemies out that way as well. I'm just gonna, like, guard you while you open the chest. They don't really seem that interested. Yeah, there's somebody over here too. I saw somebody. Yeah, there's a knave here. Let's break through that shield. Oh, nice. It kind of like pinballed him back and forth between us.
I saw that. Beach ball with a knave.
All right. Here we go. Bam! Yeah. Oh, cool. I could pick up a knave helmet too. Just need to ditch something out of my rucksack. I don't need... Ugh, I need everything. I don't need wax. Let's get rid of the wax. Now I should come and help you. Now we look the same. Kind of the same. Yay! I feel like we should dance to celebrate, but we've kind of been doing that already. Hey! Just doing the dancing feels so ridiculous. It's amazing.
I know, I love it.
Oh, here we go. Alright, so, rest at the campfire. This helmet looks
now
so time cool,
to see
too.
If it's really a dance of death or not.
I am kind of pessimistic about this one, to be perfectly honest. I don't think we're going to do so well.
It's funny, I brought an epic bow to cheat just in case it gets rough.
Okay. Look, I'm down with that. Oh, it's just one of these guys. Okay, I think we got this.
Yeah.
Bam! And he's coming after you, so good fun. Good luck with that. Yeah, and charging is going to be the thing that needs to be done so that... oh, I tried to do it a dance, but it, like, I got hit, and so it stopped. I think I killed one. Yes! Alright. I'm backing out of the room a little bit. Bam! Okay, there we go. Alright, so now it's just the boss, and I'm gonna eat a little bit of food. How are you going on health?
I'm good.
Alright, sweet. I think it's just my armor is really not good enough to be in here doing this. Maybe should have run some other heroic arctics before this point.
It's just more challenging this way.
Oh, absolutely. And that's what the series is all about, having a bit of a challenge and having lots of fun. Ah! I missed! Die! Sassy lasso. Getting all sassy up in here.
And say, as easy as it kind of makes it, having two people here, it also makes it challenging because, you know, you'll go to hit it and then someone else will and you miss.
Yeah, that's it. Whoop, whoop, woo!
There we go.
Hey! He goes down! Alright, so there's actually a couple of chests in this room too, which is kind of cool. Alright. Take some of that. I really do like the new design for this area because they've now got like all of these indestructible blocks mixed in with the blue, and it really, I don't know, for me it feels more kind of icy and desolate, which is really cool.
I agree. Yeah, I've liked all of SkySaga that I've experienced for the most part, but they just have really upped it with this alpha.
Oh, yeah.
And even more so in the next.
The build quality for these, like, underground kind of maze sections is just awesome. And
you another head.
You got a helmet? Nice. Yeah. My rucksack is totally full.
Yeah, I had to throw away a couple things.
Yeah. Alright,
well, there
so
it is, ladies and gentlemen, the Dance of Death.
Yeah, the Dance of Death. Successful and completed. Yeah, we're definitely going to have to come back and do more of this when we move over into Alpha 8. And I think, yeah, move and hopefully in Alpha 8 we can move on and actually get to some like Fabled level stuff and do some challenges and some Fabled level stuff. And yeah, I'd really like to have you back in again, Xavius, for some more of this type of stuff when we hit Alpha 8. So
maybe next time we do Dance of Death, we should do it in PvP.
Oh, now that would be interesting. Oh, actually, that would be really fun. I like that idea a lot.
I bet we could get Scott and Boomkin in on it.
Yes, I like it. We could do us versus Scott and Boomkin. That would be awesome. Absolutely
if
awesome.
If we can get Boomkin to work with Scott.
Okay, yeah, maybe that's not going to happen. Okay. So, yeah, there we go. That is the challenge completed. Thank you, everybody, for watching this episode. I hope you guys have enjoyed that. Huge thanks to Xavius for coming along and coming out and filming this one. And I'll see all of you in the next episode. Watch out for the Alpha 8 stuff coming very, very soon. Nice.